bugled.
Okay. Okay, can I start with apologies for absence? And I've been given apologies for Gilchrist and on Brick House is taking his place. And lately, the National Science is taking his place. I don't think we've got any other apologies. And then, can I draw your attention to the code of conduct? Can I ask if anybody's got any declaration of interest? Yes.
The revised capital programme, top skills for the ladies and ladies and environment.
Over recent weeks, from a national perspective, including locally, we've been
the general public informed of the specific responsibilities that they'll need to undertake over the coming weeks and months. I think the key element that we draw your attention to, Chair, is paragraph 2.3, which actually demonstrated that as far as our comparator with other local authorities and with the DCLGs, the cabinet offices, electoral role and the national government support mechanisms, we identified that we were above national average in terms of our preparations for IER. That's not to say that we are in a comfort zone, still a fair bit to do. It's critically important, this, and I think this is one of the issues that was drawn out by the panel working group themselves, was that in terms of us achieving, I think it was around a 90-92% success rate in terms of our IER versus other government data information. The risk, of course, is that still leaves a number of people, a great number of people, unregistered in rural, and it's really incumbent upon us to make sure that we do our level best as our organisation to encourage people to take up this model, and that's what the focus of our work has been and will continue to be. We have, as I said, publicly notified all of the people who are on the electoral roll that they don't need to do anything, they're actually now covered, and our efforts now are therefore process to ensure that we get close to 100% as we possibly can. Yes, please. They need to undertake that themselves. That's the whole notion of the change, of course. It does mean that it is an individual responsibility. It's not a household responsibility. It's actually for you as an individual. So if you can point to Kate Robinson in the electoral team here, then that would be great.
They can go to a one-stop shop.
They can. If they go to a one-stop shop, they'll be supported to make sure that contact is made. Against the guidance that we were given from the Electoral Commission. Interestingly, one of the local authorities who did amend the documentation have received far more complaints than we have. The reality is it is confusing. We've taken the decision so far not to send anything out that might try to clarify and then make the situation even more confusing. But we appreciate that the letters have only gone out in the last 2 to 3 weeks. So we'll keep an eye on that, and if we do pick up any further impact on people's feelings, that it does lend to further confusion, then we'll reconsider our position. But currently, we're not proposing to send any further clarification out at this moment in time. If nothing else, it adds to confusion, but also adds to the cost of doing it.
Thank you, Chair. Just on 2.3, it says that IDOC is ordering private non-registration in deprived areas, and we have a match rate of 91.5%. Is there any way to see what rules might be affected in the rules there, and then what steps are going to be taken?
Suitable work done in the review. Yeah, suitable work has done on the match rate to identify which rules were most at risk.
And the moved through the decision making process in the past year. But I'd be interested to hear what members say, because for me, I would like the committee to do a shortish piece of work on this after we've done the chance when we get into the new year. But that's my suggestion, and it's one that may not find place for us after the year. But I would like to hear what the committee think. And if you don't mind, I can go into some detail about the committee and how they work and some of the things that I would like to see them go on. Not too much of that, but general, whether you feel it's best or the question is the general answer now. But also whether you feel this would be a suitable piece of work for us to look at in more detail on that evening.
Thank you, Chair.
Yeah, mine's a note of clarification, really. Our committee in West Woodham, it's working well.
I did specifically say that. Sorry, I don't want to put you on the knees, but I did specifically say not too much detail about individual committees and how they're working on,
okay.
Unless it relates to the work, which you don't mind.
Yeah, not at all, Chair. Not at all. Clarification. I thought the decision making process was we did it in the fall. And then we came back to the town hall for approval.
my question is, it's sort of a general comment, and I think Chair is picking up really what you said earlier. What doesn't necessarily concern me, but we had, whenever it was, 12, 18 months ago, we had quite a big fanfare about this setting up of these constituency committees. And certainly I got the impression that we were increasingly going to align many of the services that the council operates on constituency basis, and that over a period of time, more decision making would be devolved to the committees. And certainly, I think, is George Davis still the lead? I don't know, but I mean, he was definitely the lead and was very enthusiastic about that. I just get the impression that we've faltered a little on that, but am I being unreasonable? Or I think that's the area where I would just like to understand the sort of direction of travel, where we're going on that.
Well, perhaps that is a bit at this point I might make my recommendation, because the recommendations that stand in the 12-point is that we coordinate the committee notes of progress on decision making processes in the constitutional committee, and I wouldn't mind, if you wouldn't mind, I'd like to change that recommendation to coordinate the committee notes of progress on developing constituency committees, but feel that it would be helpful for this constituent to make the focus work.
This is the regular monitoring that you've seen over the last 18 months since we've been introduced this particular mode of challenge and scrutiny. What you have in front of you this evening, members, are the latest position as regards the report as of 31st of July. You'll see, hopefully, if there are coloured documents in front of you, that the documents highlights where we are on target in green, where we may be slightly off target, or issues might have arisen in terms of the monitoring up to the 31st of July may not be quite in sync in their rate of December. But also we do have two reds. And in line with our usual policy, we have asked the key people to lead on these to produce an exception report. One I think is tabled in front of you this evening, which relates to performance appraisals. And one was circulated with the report, which relates to our health checks. Chair, in terms of following those two items, we had anticipated that Julie Webster from the Public Health Team would be here to answer any questions from members. Of course, she's not here, but I don't know why. So I'm sure we still take the questions, and I'll certainly take those back to Julie and make sure that the committee has got a full response in due course. And in terms of the performance appraisals, I'm happy to take any comments or questions about that.
Any questions?
Andy?
Okay. Well, the question is really that the report, the exception report, says that all performance appraisals to be carried out in June to August. So as we're now in September, is this performance indicator that doing all right? Is it now okay? Is it now transitioned?
It's not. We have failed to hit our target on this. As you can see from the actions that we were proposing, actually these actions have been put in place. We have seen an improvement over recent weeks in terms of the numbers of performance appraisals that have taken place. We are consistently, and even today, the Chief Executive has sent out a note to all heads of service to remind them of their obligation to fulfil
is not a tick box exercise. This isn't just a case of it needs to be done. It needs to be done because it actually is important to our culture and our values, and is extremely important in this time of change, change and challenge for us. Because not only does it address the council's perspective in terms of its key aims and objectives, it's also important to provide the staff with the right level of support for their particular developments and performance therein. So I'm absolutely committed to get this right. No, we are not on target at this moment in time, but I really hope that when we come back in our future performance framework, we will have identified significant improvements. There is one element in which I would say that there is some areas of mitigation. Clearly, we want to do this for the whole of the organisation. We do have groups of staff who may not be around at certain times of the year, thinking in terms of the support that we provide, for example, to maybe school Christmas patrols or to other linked seasonal workers. But even taking those out, I would still hold my hands up and say that we've not achieved that as large as we should have done.
Thank you, Chair. Just on top checks, it's disappointing that we're not able to handle any more questions and then we go far. It's now that the local authority has responsible to support the CAP. I understand these large sharing sessions are not just being. I understand that these public health delivery sessions are done in GP practices. Why was that? Why didn't go to other healthcare providers and other healthcare providers do health checks? Why were they included in monitoring? And I probably have to do a high mind interest on that, but
choose my employees.
Nevertheless, I'm sure any key points that members want to make carefully.
We've got to talk about these two pensions. First pension is on the revenue part, which is, and second pension is on the different pensions that have been published for the metrics. So, in terms of revenue margin, as you mentioned, this is up period 2 in May. Our forecast period 2 was 3.4 million.